Hello everyone, my name is Dennis and today we're gonna talk about Uber acquisition of Postmates July 6, 2020. And first I would like to say that I own some shares of Postmates, and this news a little bit sad for me, because I think that Uber is a very shitty company, and I think that it will never reach profitability, and I have video about Uber. You can find it somewhere here. Deal: Uber to acquire 100% of Postmates in an all-stock transaction. Transaction overview: that transaction is valued at approximately $2.65 billion on a fully diluted basis, subject to a net debt adjustment. Postmates stockholders will receive 100% of stock consideration. Uber equity issued in the transaction will be valued at $31.45 based on Uber 10-day VWAP as of June 29, 2020. Uber has committed to provide bridge financing to Postmates during the process of obtaining regulatory approvals. Financial impact: expected to enhance Uber its financial profile and accelerate Uber's path to profitability. Estimated 200 million plus of run rate synergies expected to achieve 1 year effect close. Timing and approvals: Postmates stockholders representing a majority of Postmates outstanding shares have committed to support the transaction. The transaction is subject to customer closing conditions, including applicable regulatory approvals and approval of Postmates stockholders, expected to close in Q1 2021. And if you didn't understand anything of this, with a simple word, I am like a Postmate stockholders will receive some shares of Uber, and the price is fixed for June 29. If I own for $1,000 in Postmate stock right now, I will receive 31 shares of Uber somewhere in Q1 2021. And it will be really sad if somewhere in Q1 2021 Uber stock will cost like $10 or $5, and it will be really great if Uber stock will cost like $60. Postmates overview: 643 million in gross booking and 107 million in revenue, 10 million plus active customers and 115,000 partner restaurants. Southwest regional leadership with high quality restaurant selection like Las Vegas, Los Angeles, Orange County, popular local here brands Sugarfish. Online food delivery is large, growing and dynamic. Online delivery penetration up to 2025, and we can see a really nice growth in billions and in a penetration, but we have a really strong competition like Grubhub, DoorDash and some other. And here we can see a really nice table where you can measure Uber Eats and Postmates, and the main idea that combines global scale and local categories, strange drive operating efficiency and accelerate path to profitability. Improved high quality restaurant selection, including SMB restaurants and local favorites. Expanded and strong customer base. Addition of a strong trusted consumer and restaurant facing brand. Integrated platform with improved batching and chaining capabilities. Technology and operations to facilitate delivery for non-partnered merchants and acceleration of delivery as a service efforts. If we will review this table, we can see that Uber Eats, it is a really big, interesting worldwide thing, and Postmates, it is like more small and local thing, and the merge can be really interesting. Q2 gross booking growth of over 100% over year. Q2 gross booking growth of over 67% year of year and over 50% quarter to quarter. Cities like London, Paris, Lisbon, Tokyo, Sydney, Toronto, Mexico City. And here on Postmates, it is more local. Los Angeles, Las Vegas, unreal amount of restaurants and customer base. I think the merge can be a really good thing. Anticipate 200 plus million dollars of run rate synergies 1 year after close. And the main idea that if Uber eats plus Postmates, it will be more choice and lower prices for customers, increased demand and lower cost for restaurants, and more work opportunities and improved earnings for delivery people. And here you can see a coffee in Uber plus 84 million shares for Uber. It is a really small piece of shares. It wouldn't make any impact for the price. And we can see here a really nice article on Seeking Alpha. Postmates has a lot to prove, so does Uber Eats. Uber has a lot on its plate already as a company is still failing to show up a profit despite seeing exponential growth in revenue over the last few years. A combination of two loss-making companies, in my opinion, is not better than one, especially if the combined business entity still happens to trail the market leader by a considerable margin. And it is really funny because one company changing the papers for another company and it cost $2.6 billion. Really funny. Uber revenue and income chart looks really bad, and operating margin minus 60%, gross margin really low, only 33. With these numbers, as I always say, they could never reach profitability. As a stockholder of Postmates, I'm hoping that this downtrend would end and I will double my money or something like this. And we can see that more than 30,000 people really like that news and they bought more Uber shares. I hope that Uber price will grow, but I really don't believe in the business. I hope this video was helpful. Don't forget to push like button and subscribe button. See you later. Bye bye.